The elbows did it, Brandon goes down!
Vera is ready to go! It's insanity! It's good! Nine! Freaking Irene!
Here he is, the champ.
The champ, Aung La Aung Sam himself, has been the face of ONE Championship the past 2 or 3 years.
The rabid attention that he gets from the Burmese people is a sight to see.
Check it out, two incredible athletes in the ring at the same time. Martin Nguyen is something special, isn't he?
Here he's showing off his signature kick. If you've never heard Aung La kick the pads, it is thunderous. Every kick that he throws is so loud.
Oh, let's listen. Let's not speak for a little bit. It's all Martin could do to stay on his feet, my goodness. Aung La Aung San, there he is.
We're at the Park Hyatt Hotel in Tokyo, and we just had our the Century press conference. I think the world is going to be excited for this event.
Thank you so much. I love you guys. You guys are amazing. Thank you. I feel good. Just ready to get back in the gym and get some work in, clean up some technique. Thank you guys so much. Final words. Love you guys. Hey, Myanmar fans, Jeju Myahatimare, Along. You guys made me who I am. I want to thank God. Without them, I wouldn't be the man that I am. And thank you to my teammates here, my trainer, Henry Hoof, Coach Greg, Tommy Barzini, Corey Peacock. Thank you, guys. I would never be this good without you guys. Thank you.
Myanmar, stand up! And still the one light heavyweight world champion, Aung La Aung
been commentating in Japan since 2001, and I've never heard a crowd as loud as this. Brandon Vera has never gotten beyond the first round in his one career. 4-0 first round finishes. Aung La Aung San at 92% finishing rate. Finished his last 5 opponents, including 3 in the first round. He'll look for the steel pipe, he calls it, the right hand, and look for the fadeaway lead hook of Brandon Vera. The size of Aung La. Aung La may have the power in the hand. Vera will have the speed. I've been training earlier.
Aung La Aung San is about the kicks. He's got beautiful foot techniques to pay very close attention to what he's doing with his legs.
Aung La comes from a replay background for the National Martial Art of Myanmar. They have turned out in force tonight. Myanmar flags are flying, so too Filipino flags for Brandon Vera. Vera off the back leg. Doubles up into Vera. Power salvos early from the legs of the troop. Body shot, belly button through the back from Aung La Aung San. Outside leg kick from Aung La. Checks the low kick to Brandon. on that face. Wants to throw the steel pipe. Throws the steel pipe. Looks for the gap to hook. Try for the Muay Thai clinch there. Did Brandon Vera. Vera switches. Vera in southpaw stance now. The left hand's now the power hand. Aung edging forward. Roundhouse kick scooped away by Vera. Scooped away by Aung.
Body shots.
Looping left hand there from Aung. Cracking out some leg kick from Aung inside. Tremendous power from both these men. Spinning hook kick from Aung.
Brandon Vera's been working on those leg techniques. He knows that Aung Lan Son wants to come in with the kicks. Brandon Vera's looking to counter.
Aung Lan fights. Gets out of the way of the long-reaching left hand. It's all for the stance now for Vera. He circles on captain block one. Back to center circle. Both men trade hooks.
You can hear the entire left side of the stadium is absolutely quiet while the right side is just pulsing the energy.
High kick there from Aung Lan. Brandon throws the jab.
Counters down the gap. Aung Lan Son catches him with the jab coming in.
Aung Lan dances forward. Left hook to right hand. Looks for a fadeaway hook up and right there to Brandon Vera.
This is already Brandon Vera's longest match of the championship.
Brandon Vera had only paid in the short term.
Inside that clinch. Nice hand combination thrown by Aung Lan Son.
Brandon said he wanted Aung Lan in a phone booth. He welcomed it in. He gave him the dime to make the phone call on the inside.
We talked a lot about the counter-striking coming from Brandon Vera, but Aung Lan Son is not paying any attention to it. He has no fear marching forward, throwing big shots.
First round of five. We're not going to go to five. Surely not. Not in this one. Fight there. And a crossing elbow. Muay Thai. From Brandon Vera. 59% of fans believe Aung Lan wins tonight. 41% say Brandon Vera.
Again, a big body kick thrown by Brandon Vera. He's also setting up. You can see the way kind of Aung Lan Son protects the body. I'd like to see Brandon Vera fake the body kick over the head punch.
The big question tonight. If Aung Lan tests the jaw of Vera, no one in one championship is yet to cleanly hit the jaw of Brandon Vera. But Aung Lan's got the steel pipe. Can he land it? Goes for the headmaker. The overhead right.
Barely misses that shot. Brandon Vera was just able to get his hand up in time. Ooh, Brandon Vera steps inside with the uppercut elbow.
45 seconds to go in the first round.
I like
that's
the leg kicks.
A magnificent opener.
I like the leg kicks coming from Aung Lan Son. He's got to do more of that. Slow down that movement. Slow down that constant stance switches coming from Brandon Vera.
Brandon back to southpaw stance. Gets out by the round kick. Back to center circle. This crowd rabid in Tokyo. They are loving every moment of it. The main event of one century.
There's some of those body kicks are getting through, Michael. You can hear that thud. It's like a baseball bat cracking.
Vera circles off to his right. Drifting away from the power side of Aung Lan, away from the steel pipe. Aung Lan fakes it. There's the drift away hook. There's a lead hook from Brandon. Aung Lan smiles at it. And we go to the towels at the end of one. Folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms. At One Championship on Facebook, on Twitter, and on Instagram.
Look at this. Brandon Vera rushes forward, barely misses with a knee, but a beautifully timed elbow inside the clinch landed by Brandon Vera. Oh, and the knee just barely grazes the jaw of Aung Lan Son. I like how Aung Lan Son's moving forward, though. I like how he changes stances. He comes in with that big right hand. He's in southpaw stance. I'd like to see him keep going with it. Man, you can hear the whole hush kind of fall over this crowd on that one side. You can hear Martin Nguyen in the corner.
Mitch, how about this? Aung Lan standing between rounds. Brandon Vera took a seat. You read anything into that?
Brandon Vera's a veteran. He knows how to recover. But this is the first time he's been in the sixth minute of a match. This is the whole uncharted territory.
Brandon Vera hasn't been into the second round of a match since 2013. More than 6 years ago,
Brandon Vera says that's not a problem. He consistently trains hard in the fourth and fifth round. He is happy to be in deep water. He wants to get taken into the deep end and see what kind of metal he's really got.
It's been all standing so far. We haven't gone to the ground. On the ground, Vera has one sub. Ongla has 12 submissions. 5 guillotines, 5 arm bars included.
Yeah, Michael, I don't know if this is going to go to the ground. I think these guys want to put on a show, and they are looking for a knockdown.
Just a slip there for Ongla. Overhand right, he kind of couldn't get sloppy. Because I believe Vera beats him for speed and precision. Outside leg kick to that common perennial nerd, just above the lead knee from Ongla.
Every time Brandon's an orthodox, Ongla's son is touching that lead leg. You can see a beautiful check there.
You see the Baybayin Filipino writing on the back of Brandon Vera.
These guys got iron chins. They are eating each other's best shots, and they're still standing. It's going to take a remarkable effort to put one of these two monsters down.
Step through knee from Vera. After he threw a crossing elbow. Ongla comes forward, always plodding forward. He wants to drill the steel pipe to the jaw. Both men in southpaw stance.
Those low kicks are starting to touch Brandon. You can see how he's taking them. He's stepping gingerly on those legs.
The low kicks will slow down the boxing of Brandon Vera. Vera tries the Muay Thai clinch and knee, hoping for the meet and greet. Inside leg there from Ongla. Got to watch that drift away lead hook of Brandon Vera. That's what he knocked out Mauro Cirilli with. What's the gas tank like of Brandon Vera at light heavyweight in the second round? Round kick from Vera.
Starting to move, beautiful little roundhouse kick to a straight left hand there, landed by Vera. Ongla's son seems unfazed by the power. He's wearing these punches very well.
Ongla eats a stiff left hand from Brandon. And continues to come forward, swings the legs again.
Came with a big leg kick. You can see Brandon starting to get a little bit wobbly. I don't know if he's hurt him though. Brandon Vera was starting to wobble just ever so slightly, but then look at the spinny back elbow connects to the side of the head. Brandon Vera thought about answering with one of his own. He crumbles to the ground, and Ongla jumps all over him, and he just starts landing big punches. Look at the left hand. Olivier Cost was forced to call a halt to the action because Aung Lan was just letting it go. Hurt him with a big knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 double digit unanswered punches.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 23 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, and still one light heavyweight world champion, Aung San!
Amazing scenes here in Tokyo. An amazing performance from Aung Lan Sang. You cosmic kite, where did you come from? Myanmar's national hero, their national treasure, their only world champion of anything.
I just,
and nice to see we are trending with the world championship. Ready, hashtag ready, number one trend on Twitter in the USA right now. Southpaw stars on Kim Hasegawa. This one brought to you by Global Citizen. Last time, the all-time greatest bout in one championship history. Until in the fifth round, Aung Lan Sang uncorked the uppercut of all uppercuts to knock out Kim Hasegawa. He says it'll happen quicker tonight. It may be a roundhouse kick to the head that knocks out Hasegawa. Before that knockout last time, Hasegawa had never been knocked out in his illustrious career.
Yeah, it was absolutely beautiful. It was like you were watching a Street Fighter the video game, the way that he landed that beautiful uppercut. And Hasegawa's stance is a little bit awkward. He comes out of the southpaw stance, but he angles his body in a very peculiar way. He's consistently stepping up the outside of the foot of Aung Lan Sang. So it gives Aung Lan Sang a little bit of trouble, and he spoke about it earlier with us. He says he's come up with a plan with his coach, Henry Hoof, to combat that.
Aung Lan Sang, who appeared world champion, Martin Ewan into his camp in Florida for this one. Then Hasegawa ventured out of Japan, went to New York to train up for this. Aung Lan, car batteries of hands. Massive power in both those fists. During his introduction by Dom Lau, you saw him hit his elbow. That was in tribute to the national striking martial art of Myanmar called Lat Wai. Tremendous martial art, similar to Kun Kamai of Cambodia or Muay Thai of Thailand. Body shot there from Aung Lan Sang. Hasegawa franks. Southpaw Hasegawa retains Aung Lan, wants to employ his right hand down the center corridor. Keep his lead foot on the outside of Hasegawa's lead foot to employ that right hand. Chance in part of the audience here for Hasegawa. Other chance from the Burmese fans for Aung Lan Sang. Hasegawa gets back to center cage. Beautiful kick to the left ribs, and it's already so red it looks like it's been sunburned. Jab two there from Hasegawa.
You see the game plans are pretty evident. Aung Lan Sang wants to create that pressure, keep Ken Hasegawa up against the cage, but Hasegawa's doing a good job of moving laterally and keeping away from the back of the cage.
Last time out, Hasegawa put a beating on Aung Lan Sang at times, the likes of which we'd never seen before. Aung Lan's face after that contest was an absolute horror show. And he backs him up with a two-punch combination. Here's the heavy artillery from Aung Lan. Hasegawa's face reddened, his body reddened. He just grins, he smiles, and bites down on his mouth guard. They are barking instructions at Hasegawa from his corner. Aung Lan following him around the cage, resets now. Backs away the roundhouse kick again, scooped away by Ken Hasegawa. The deep open weight tournament champion goes to the inside thigh, goes upstairs on Aung Lan. Good right hand back. on the four paces. That had some starch behind it. Here's Aung on the front foot. Sagawa stands his ground. Look at the kaleidoscope of colours on that left rib section of Hasegawa. The purples and the reds from the damage of those roundhouse kicks off the back leg of the world's champion.
That right side has given Ken Hasegawa a lot of problems.
Oh, smack back! Smack back! He landed the right hand! And Hasegawa momentarily found the canvas. Hasegawa straight back to his feet. He'll want to duke it out. Flash of leg kicks. Aung now might have drawn there. Short straw. Under a minute remaining, first round set for five. Probing jabs from the champion, Aung San Suu, going for the headache maker. Can he get a takedown here, Hasegawa? Slow the striking of Aung San Suu.
This is where Aung San Suu said Ken Hasegawa is giving the most problems. It's inside that clinch. It's the judo of Ken Hasegawa. That's that Aung San Suu has to look out for. Now he's just going for the upper body clinch. He's not attempting to create any sort of angles to do the throws.
Under half a minute remaining in what has been a cracker of a first round for the champion, Aung San Suu. Probing fires the right hand down the tube there. Uppercut went higher than my cholesterol. Resets at Hasegawa. We get some much needed instructions between rounds here, Ken Hasegawa. High kick from Aung San Suu. Goes to the body once more, countered by Hasegawa. We go to the towels.
Good first round for the champ. He's finding a home with that right hand.
Have a look at that. Vitor Belfort recently signed to one championship in the house. Along with our many luminaries here tonight. So many famous faces around the Rio Goku Koku Gikan in Tokyo.
Look at this right hand of Aung San Suu, parries the right hand of Ken Hasegawa and then straight down the middle drops the challenger. It's that right side of Aung San Suu that is giving Ken Hasegawa so many problems. Whether it's the battering right leg body kick or if it's that straight right hand, Ken Hasegawa has got to change it up. I like him inside the clinch. I want to see him at least attempt to take down, get Aung San Suu thinking about another option. But Ken Hasegawa is right now just standing in front of Aung San Suu and allowing Aung San Suu to find that range and that distance and connect on that right side.
Ready? Round two for the world middleweight title. The champion in the white, Aung San Suu of Myanmar. The challenger in the black and white, Ken Hasegawa of Japan.
Good stop there from Aung San Suu as Ken Hasegawa tried to change things up and went for that double leg, but Aung San Suu saw it coming.
Big hello to all of our fans watching live in Myanmar on Skynet and MNTV. Watching here in Japan on Abima TV and TV Tokyo. Thought about the high roundhouse kick there with the champion Aung San Suu. And who once plied a trade as a beekeeper. Sagawa looking to land the leather. Hooks off the lead. Wild uppercut, little back fist there from Aung San Suu. Roundhouse kick from Aung San Suu, trying for the catch and counter did. Hasegawa goes to the inside thigh. Aung San Suu goes for the bread basket. Left hand, I should say right hook there, on a southpaw stance from Ken Hasegawa. Both men are loading up with the punches here in the second round, Dragon. Jab two there from Aung San Suu.
What we're seeing from Aung San Suu is that parrying of the lead hand of Ken Hasegawa. Ken's got to be very careful because he's leaving, he's exposing himself right down the middle because Ken Aung San Suu is not only stepping out to his left, but he's parrying the hand and coming right down the middle with that right hand of his.
If there's one thing we know from their first contest, it's that Ken Hasegawa is a human sponge. This man can absorb all the punishment in the world you can throw at him. It's going to take another Herculean effort for Aung San Suu to knock him out for a second time. And this crowd, which is very uncharacteristic in Japan, are cheering for both Hasegawa and Aung San Suu. two-punch combination there from Aung La. Hasegawa gets off his left hand, that being the power hand of the southpaw. Body kick from Aung La. Got to be careful not to drop that lead hand. Look out for that right-hand counter of Hasegawa. Oh, smack bang with the schnoz there with the cross from Aung La.
Right now, that body kick is definitely starting to drop the hand of Hasegawa. It's exposing the whole left side of his face.
Ongar consistently pouring with that lead hand to find range and timing for that right. You go to Myanmar and you just can't believe how riotously popular, how famous Ongar's son is. Come on, walk the street. Cannot go anywhere without being mobbed. He's picked on billboards, on TV commercials, radio commercials. You talk to cab drivers, you talk to waiters, chefs, you talk to plumbers, you talk to the hotel staff. Everyone knows the name Aung La San in Myanmar, a country of some 55 million people. Where it's said that one in every three watches him live when he competes. Jab two there from Aung La. Roundhouse kick from the champion. Again from Aung La San. Systematically, methodically, breaking down Hasegawa. Oh, that ribcage of Hasegawa is an absolute mess.
Looks like a Ziploc bag full of hamburger meat. Oh, with a nice knee there on the entry and the takedown. It's about time Ken Hasegawa thought about a takedown.
Can Hasegawa change it up here? Can he change the levels? Get this match on the ground. Side of Hasegawa's carcass looks like it's been barbecued. What punishment he's taken? Crossing elbow, leg-way style there from Aung La San. Hasegawa needs to protect that body. Aung La's going to wind up those roundhouse kicks. It's like a painted target for the shins of Aung La San. There he goes again, careening into the side.
Just that, Aung La San reigns supreme outside of Myanmar and is still unstoppable.
It was the right side of Aung La San all night long. He was finding a home with the body kick. He softened up the body, broke down the entire ribcage of Ken Hasegawa. He was stepping out to the lead side, and then that right hand came straight down the middle and dropped Hasegawa. He figured out the puzzle a lot faster. We gotta take a look at this again. Look at this, boom, right down the middle. He saw Ken Hasegawa was actually coming into it, and then boom, right down the middle. What a thing of beauty. He waited for it. Look at that, he creates the opening. Look at that, he's stepping on the foot of Ken Hasegawa. There was no place for him to go. That, those small little intricate details of Aung La San.
Amazing scenes once again. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, please welcome the founder, chairman, and CEO of One Championship, Chatri Sichodong. And now, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 41 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout, and still your one middleweight world champion, Aung La San.
The Myanmar flag over his shoulder, and also his world title belt presented to him by the CEO and founder of One Championship, Chatri Sichodong. Amazing. A knockout, as he called it, Aung La San.